Hello, future scientists! In Unit 3, Living and Growing, we will still explore, discuss, and describe the difference between living and non-living things, and you will learn things that are alive or never been alive. Remember that birds, insects, animals, trees, human beings just like you are a few examples of living things, as they have the same characteristic features like eating, breathing, reproduction, growth, and development, and a lot more. You will also learn and explain that different animals live in different places. Remember that things that are alive eat, breathe, move, use their senses, and grow, such as this caterpillar, a giraffe, a butterfly, they are considered living things. The term living thing refers to things that are now or once were alive, whereas a non-living thing is anything that was never alive. In order for something to be considered as living, again, it must grow and develop, use energy, reproduce, respond to its environment, and adopt. Now decide whether each thing is living, dead, or has never been alive. What about this lion? All right, how about this plant or this sunflower? Okay, it is a living. And this baby also is a living thing. How about this wooden table? These candies? How about this flower vase? This saucepan? How about the soccer ball? And how about this bowl? Alright, yes, you are all correct. Remember, they are living because they move, eat, breathe, grow, and use their senses. Now, these are considered never alive because they do not move, eat, breathe, and grow. And for this flower vase, it is considered dead. Now let's go for a walk. Look for things that are living. Also look for things that have never been alive. If you have camera, take photos of things that you find or make a list of things that are alive or have never been alive. Then try to make comparisons between things that are alive or not alive, and then tell others about why something is alive or has never been alive. This is a short story for kids about living and non-living things. Please try to watch this video and you will enjoy this one. Living things need places to live. Different living things live in different places. Not just the humans, all plants and animals are living because they can grow and reproduce, need food, water, and air, move and respond, or adapt to their environment. The places where they live are called habitats. Habitats can be very big or very small. Look at these pictures of some habitats. The whale lives in the sea. The sea is a big habitat. And this hairy caterpillar lives on leaves. A leaf is a small habitat. The meerkat lives in a burrow. The sunbird lives in trees. Burrow and trees are very small habitats. The area where a particular organism lives naturally is called its habitat. These are some types of habitat: the ocean, aquatic, rainforest, polar, and a lot more. And a good habitat must provide food, water, cover, space, and arrangement for these animals. Watch this video. It explains about animal habitats or their animal homes. A pond is a habitat too. It is an area filled with water, either natural or artificial, that is smaller than a lake. In this habitat, you will find different living things, such as insects, water plants, and even animals. Now, talk to a partner. What kinds of animals live near you? Try to draw pictures of animals that live near you. You can draw animals that live in trees, in water, on the ground, or even under the ground. Now, challenge yourself. How do you know that you are alive? Good job, future scientist. Till next time, thank you.